Hi there, this is Dr. Sheena from Qi Medicine Acupuncture in Moonee Ponds, your local Chinese medicine practitioner. And today I wanted to talk to you about basal body temperature charting and how it can be a really useful tool when you're looking to get pregnant. We use basal body temperature charting in the clinic regularly as a really effective tool for helping us to diagnose and treat issues with fertility, so we can have a look at what's happening with your body by looking at your chart. So it's something that we often do require our clients to, that it can be an amazing tool, and it gives you so much information about what's going on with your cycle that it's really valuable. So I wanted to show you how you can do your BBT charting, for short, basal body temperature charting, at home, and to understand exactly what you're looking at, and so you understand why it is so important. So basically, a basal body temperature chart, now every chart is different, and there is no such thing as a perfect chart, but generally speaking, they look like this. So this is using Fertility Friend, and this is something that we'll put up on the website as well. But you can see here that there are two, it's called biphasic, there's two distinct areas or cycles in this is the menstrual cycle, the whole menstrual cycle. And this is the follicular phase, the first phase, which starts from day one of your period. We always say that day one is the first day of your period, and that's the first day of proper bleeding is day one. So from day one to ovulation, around in the middle, around about the middle, and then the luteal phase, which is that second half. And generally, a period can be anywhere from 26 to 32 days. It does vary quite a lot. There's no such thing as a perfect period time, perfect period month, because every woman is different, and you can have a longer or a shorter cycle, and it still is a perfectly normal cycle. So what we're doing here, this is from, as I said, Fertility Friend, which is a free app that you can use, which we recommend, fertilityfriend.com, and you can find it in your app store, both Apple and Android. One of the best apps to actually chart your BBT with, because we find it to be the most reliable with its data and the easiest to read. So download Fertility Friend. And when you start tracking, this is every day, these temperatures are put in each morning after you wake up, and then you'll end up getting this chart throughout the month. So we're not only looking at your most likely fertile days, we're also looking at your overall temperature, what's happening with cervical mucus, which is really important as well, and what other things might be at play. So there might be some infection or other issues going on that we don't know about. This will help us to figure everything out and help us to treat you accordingly in Chinese medicine. Say if you're a little bit too hot or if you're a little bit too cold, we can help to balance you out, so which will give you better health and better outcomes overall, which is wonderful. So to take your temperature, what you need to do is get a good quality digital thermometer. So this is one that we supply in the clinic, and you don't have to go for the fancy $300 one. They're not necessarily any better than a good quality digital thermometer. These ones cost about $15. The trick with getting a really good reading every single time is there are a couple of rules with taking your morning temperature. Number one is that you need to have at least 3 hours sleep. And that's one block of a 3 hour sleep. So if you are getting up throughout the night, maybe you've got a toddler as well, or something else going on, or even you're a shift worker, that's okay. As long as you have a 3 hour gap, a 3 hour block, and you take your temperature after that. Because what we're doing is getting the base, the lowest possible temperature, which is the basal body temperature, the lowest possible temperature of your body at that time. And that is the reading that we want. And that will only really be after that good block of 3 hours sleep. So first rule, 3 hours sleep, no less. When you wake up, it is very, very important that you do not drink, no water, no coffee, You do not speak. Don't roll over and talk to your partner or your cat. You do not get out of bed, so no movement, and you don't do any activity, because any of those activities will interrupt your temperature. They'll bring them up or bring your temperature up, or it will create some other disturbance. So once again, no speaking, no drinking, no eating, no movement of any kind. The only movement we want you to do is reach over and grab this and stick it in your mouth. And the thermometer, you turn it on till it beeps and you can see the screen. Pop it in your mouth, same side each time. Hold it in your mouth until it beeps, and don't talk, just take that temperature, and then you'll get the reading once that's done, and pop it in your app, in your phone, and it's as simple as that. You can write it down if you want and pop it in later, but it is important to write that down so you can pop that in your app. And you will need to do that if we're undergoing a course of treatment focused on helping you with your fertile health. It is important that you do this every single day and you don't miss days. There are things that will affect your readings. So one of them is alcohol. If you drink, that warms you up, that will disrupt your reading. If you're sick, that will also give a different reading, and lots of other things. If you are highly stressed, if you've just had a big fight with your partner, there will be fluctuations, and you will see that your chart, this one's kind of fairly straightforward, but you'll see that there's some sawtoothing going up and down, and that's really normal. And so it's going to look something like this, and sometimes it looks nothing like this. And if that's the case, then it's really important that we know what's causing that. So you will be able to detail in the notes with Fertility Friend if there were any changes that day, anything you did differently, and we can go through that in your session. So once you've taken your temperature, plotted it in, it will work out what those temperatures are. You can also see down here there are areas to track your mucus, cervical mucus, which is also quite telling with fertility. It will help to inform us when perhaps your most fertile days are. You can track that down here. That's a sort of a cervical mucus. You can tell us what time you had intercourse as well. That's really important. We know you're actually trying to make babies. And also your period, when you had bleeding, spotting, etc. So all that information is really good to know. So plot it all in your chart. And by the end of that, you will know, have a really good idea of where you are with your basal body temperature and how Chinese medicine can help you, and what we can do to influence your temperatures or your cycle to regulate it. So you'll have a healthier cycle and be more likely to have happy, healthy babies. So that is essentially how to track your basal body temperature. It's not just about when you're ovulating, it's also about the health of your body. So really vitally important to get all that information to us when you see us next at your treatment. So I hope that was really informative. And of course, if you've got any questions about fertility or BBT charting or cervical mucus or anything, please get in contact with us at www.qimedicine.com. .com.au. Our doctors are really keen to help answer any questions you might have, and we hope you have a wonderful day. We look forward to seeing you in the clinic. Bye from me.